Hello aviation friends, welcome to this quite special video. After a couple of great days of plane spotting at Madeira, it's time to start heading home. But it turned out that Madeira had one last surprise to offer. It's exactly 6 o'clock in the morning as me and my travel buddy for this trip, Stefan, arrive at Funchal Madeira Airport. The great thing about this airport is that everything is pretty well to do on foot. It's about a 30-minute walk from our accommodation to the airport. The airport is not huge, but I'd say very conveniently sized. Nothing is very far away and there are observation decks for plane spotting both before and after security. Our journey home back to the Netherlands will start with a Ryanair flight to Lisbon. The security process goes smoothly. Soon we are already pre-boarded for our flight. It's EI-GXI, a 3-year-old Boeing 737-800 which is on its way to pick us up. The plane was based at Lisbon during that time, so it needed to come from there. However, strong winds are blowing at Madeira, and the inbound planes, including ours, are put in a holding pattern. In our minds, we think they will try an approach soon, and if that fails, they will divert to the nearby island of Porto Santo. But none of that happened. Our plane turned back to Lisbon. Soon the realization came to us and the other passengers that this might become a very long day. The winds did not die down, and as you can see, more flights either diverted or were cancelled. Reliable information was hard to find. First we were told we would fly in the afternoon, but the new flight time kept getting delayed all the way until 12:30 the next day. During the evening, our plane, EI-GXI, came back. But here's the thing, it was now operating the evening Lisbon flight. This flight was fully booked, so none of the passengers on our flight were able to take this evening flight to Lisbon. This time EI-GXI attempted an actual approach, but it was aborted before the runway 05 turn. They diverted again, but now to Porto Santo. Much later in the evening they gave it another go, and this time landed first try on runway 05. No celebration yet, as we could not go on this plane to Lisbon. According to Flightnr, EI-GXI was still scheduled to do our flight, which meant it first needed to go back to Lisbon operating that evening flight I mentioned before, and then come back to do the now more than 12-hour delayed morning flight. Meanwhile, our departure time had moved to like 3 o'clock in the morning. Very little information was given, including info about where to spend the night. It looked like no one arranged a hotel. All other flights out of Madeira were either ridiculously expensive or fully booked. Me and Stefan reluctantly accepted that this would become a long night at the airport. As EI-GXI departed to Lisbon without us, we settled down in the area close to the viewing deck and tried to get some sleep. As you would expect, this did not go very well. I slept for maybe an hour when I woke up and noticed that Stefan was gone. I had no clue where he went, and he left all his stuff with me. Unreachable on the phone, I couldn't do anything but wait. Half an hour later he came back with some news. The flight was now delayed even further to 12 o'clock the next day, but they were in the process of arranging a hotel. Finally, some good news. And yes, soon we were taken to a very nice nearby hotel with lovely beds. We were so tired, so obviously slept like roses. Morning broke to the sound of airplanes. We had a great view of the final approach from our room. We had a good sleep in, and soon we were taken back to the airport. But it still was very windy, and multiple flights had big time trouble to get in. It did look somewhat better though, and soon flights began landing again. Of course, we went to the viewing deck to spot them. Amazingly, no go-arounds. I didn't film a proper go-around the whole trip, even though the wind definitely played a part. There was one go-around though, which was amazing, but it should have been on tape. Just at the moment that this EasyJet A320 went around, my camera decided to cut out. I later determined this was because of a glitch with the SD card. Really, really unlucky. It was around 12 o'clock when finally the plane where we should be flying on to Lisbon got airborne. But unbelievably, it was the 3-year-old Boeing 737-800 EI-GXI, the exact same plane which we flew on to Madeira a couple days earlier. Our flight time had moved to 13:35. We headed to security again and got through without problems. At the gate, we see a lot of familiar faces. This sign sort of sums up how we were feeling about all of this. EI-GXI flies the approach. Will they land it? Ah yes, we are in business. And so for the second time in a couple of days, we step on board EI-GXI. The views airside the Madeira airport are fantastic as usual. I take a seat in the same row as the previous flight, but this time on the other side, 23A.
We'll guide you to the nearest exit in an emergency. The exits are located on both sides of the aircraft, at the front, in the middle, and at the rear of the cabin. All exits are also shown on the safety card. The nearest exit may be behind you. In case of an emergency evacuation, you must leave all your hand baggage behind. To fasten a seatbelt, insert the metal end into the buckle and secure by pulling the loose end. To open a seatbelt, lift the buckle cover. In case of a loss of cabin pressure, masks like this will drop automatically from the panels above your heads. Remain seated and pull down firmly on the mask to stop the flow of oxygen. Place the mask over your nose and mouth, secure with the strap, and breathe normally. Don't worry if the bag does not inflate, oxygen is flowing. Fit your own mask first before helping anyone else. The life jackets are stowed in a pocket beneath your seat or in the panel above your head. If it's needed, remove the jacket from its packet and place it over your head. Bring the strap around your waist, clip at the front, and secure as shown. To inflate the life jacket, pull down sharply on the red toggle. There is a mouthpiece for further inflation or deflation and a light to attract attention. Do not inflate your life jacket until you are outside the aircraft. Before takeoff, please study the safety card located within the area you are seated, as it includes important safety information specific to this aircraft type. It is essential that cabin signs and instructions given by the crew are followed. We would like to remind you that smoking is not permitted anywhere on board. Your hand baggage must be securely stowed in the overhead locker or under the seat in front of you, and it must not block any aisle or exit. Now please ensure that your seatbelt is securely fastened, tray table folded, armrests down, and window blinds open. For your safety, we recommend that you keep your seatbelt fastened at all times. Portable electronic devices such as tablets and
da cintura e aperta à frente. Para insuflar o colete, puxe firmemente na peça.
And there we go. Finally, the journey to Lisbon has started.
E uma luz para atrair a atenção. Não insufle o colete até se encontrar fora do avião. Antes da descolagem, por favor, verifique o cartão de segurança junto do seu assento, pois contém importantes informações de segurança específicas para este modelo de avião. É essencial que respeite todos os sinais a bordo e que as instruções da tripulação estejam cumpridas. Lembramos que é proibido fumar em todos os espaços deste avião. A sua bagagem de mão deverá ser guardada no compartimento superior ou debaixo do assento à sua frente e não poderá bloquear a passagem no corredor ou nas saídas. Agora, assegure-se que o seu cinto de segurança está apertado, mesa recolhida, apoios de braço para baixo e persianas das janelas abertas. Para sua segurança, recomendamos que mantenha o cinto apertado durante todo o voo. Aparelhos eletrónicos, tais como tablets ou telemóveis, em modo de avião, podem ser usados durante o voo. Por favor, selecione o modo de avião agora e segure.
Unbelievably though, I'm dealing with some more issues. Since this morning, my phone could barely survive 5 minutes while turned on, and suddenly, the GoPro decided to turn against me as well. The stability was totally gone. I quickly tried to figure out what's wrong, but we are already backtracking on the runway.
Cabin crew seats for departure.
So yeah, try not to get seasick. This is going to be a rough takeoff. Soon after we left the ground, I switched to my camcorder. It was a spectacular high performance takeoff. After that takeoff, we continue climbing over the Atlantic Ocean, heading for mainland Portugal. I got the GoPro behaving again, and we can enjoy some of the beautiful views. After a nice flight, we start to descend to Lisbon. The approach of the Transavia flight into Lisbon earlier on this trip was stunning. And now, once again, we get treated with some beautiful views. We are already more or less lined up with runway 02, which will once again take us very low over the city. You can probably tell from the footage that here too it is quite windy. Let's see how this landing goes. quite a firm landing. But as you can hear, the passengers are happy that they finally made it to Lisbon. And so were me and Stefan. It has been a tense time, certainly not the nicest of experiences, but when you fly often, it was bound to happen someday. And Madeira is known for its difficult weather now and then. We survived and learned that not every trip goes like clockwork. I need to thank Stefan for his company on this trip. I think it all would have gone differently if I was on my own. Remember, it was Stefan who decided to go to that Ryanair desk one more time. If he didn't do that, we would most likely have spent the whole night on the airport floor instead of in a very nice hotel bed. Stefan has an Instagram page where he uploads his plane spotting pictures. It's really worth checking it out. Link is in the description. We arrive at their gate, but there is one final small hurdle to overcome, as the captain shall now explain.
Ladies and gentlemen, your captain speaking. Please remain seated. We still have to move ahead, so our parking system, the automatic parking system, is not working, so we are waiting for a marshal to guide us to our parking position. So please remain seated until we move again, and then we will release everybody once we reach the correct position. Thank you for your attention. And once more, thanks a lot for flying with Ryanair. Have a very good afternoon. Sorry, so come on.
You heard it. The automatic docking system didn't work, so an airport marshal needed to come. Thank you very much for watching this video. In the next flight video, you will hear a bit more to the story of getting home from Madeira. So stay tuned for that. Once again, thank you very much for watching and have a great day.
Cabin crew, disarm lights and open doors. Thank you.